Hello everyone, as we have reached the fag end of research methodology course, today we are going to discuss a very important topic called drawing conclusion. As you all know, I am Dr. Ritu Sharma and I have been dealing with research methodology modules, and today we are going to discuss how to draw conclusion, because that is the most important part of the research. So in this module, you will learn that to understand the role of conclusion and what role does it play in research. And then we'll also discuss the importance of a good conclusion, and we'll explain the structure of a good conclusion, and finally we'll examine the problem that we need to avoid while writing a conclusion. And we will also see various steps that we can use in the process of drawing conclusion. So drawing conclusion, as I told you, is one of the most important activities in research, as it gives the final critical reflection of the research conducted. The conclusion plays an important role as it determines the success or failure of a research. Whether we conduct a doctrinal or empirical research, it is the final conclusion that makes research a success. If the result of the research is satisfying and the experimentation is excellent but conclusion is weak, then the result of the research will not be appreciated. Thus, drawing conclusion plays a very important role. A conclusion helps the reader in understanding the research conducted and how it will be helpful to them. It also helps in paving the way for future research. It is just not a summary, but also gives key point to the research. The conclusion of a research has three important points. One, it gives an ending to your project and highlights what a research result means. Second, it helps the researcher in explaining how his or her research contributes to the new knowledge. Third, it gives an impression of the work done by the researcher. Now, when we talk about this introduction, we should also know that what is the importance of a good conclusion. And here we are going to quote David Bunton, who has pointed out the importance of a good conclusion. He says that a well-written conclusion provides you with important opportunity to demonstrate to the reader your understanding of the research problem. And these include, first, presenting the last word on the issue you raised in your paper. So, just as the introduction gives a first impression to your reader, the conclusion offers a chance to leave a lasting impression. Do this, for example, by highlighting key points in your analysis for results, or by pointing important or unexpected implications applied or practiced. Second, summarizing your thoughts and conveying the larger significance of your study. The conclusion is an opportunity to secondly, answer the question, so what, by placing the study within the context of the past research about the topic you have investigated. Then it identifies how a gap in the literature has been addressed. This is our third point. The conclusion can be where you describe how a previous identified gap in the literature described in your literature review has been filled by your research. So, it actually fulfills the gap which is already there in the research. So, when you are concluding, you give a kind of idea to the person that till now in literature this was the gap and my research is actually fulfilling that gap. Then the fourth point is it demonstrates the importance of your ideas. Now, in conclusion, when you're writing a conclusion, you should not be shy. It should offer you the opportunity to elaborate on the impact and significance of your findings. So, your idea also plays a very important role when you are actually writing a conclusion. Then, introducing possible new or expanded ways of thinking about the research problem. Once you have conducted your research, once you have got the results, you are writing a conclusion, and this writing of conclusion does not refer to introducing new information because it should be avoided, but to offer a new insight and creative approach for framing or contextualizing the research problem based on the result of your study. Because by coming to a conclusion, you have already seen the various aspects of the research, and when you are actually observing the various aspects, you also know that where a new field can also be opened after your research, right? So then it will, as a result, it will be introducing new or expanded ways of thinking about the research problem. Now, as we have understood what is the significance of a good conclusion, we should also understand what should be a structure of a good conclusion. Joseph Essen has discussed the structure and the writing style of the conclusion. He says while writing a conclusion, a researcher should follow some points. For example, first it should state the conclusion very clearly, in a very simple language, and it should state how the findings differ or support those of the others and why. It should not simply reiterate your results or the discussions of your results. It should provide a synthesis of arguments presented in the paper to show how all these coverage to address the research problems and the overall objective of your study. So it should indicate opportunities for future research if you haven't already done so in the discussion section of your paper. And finally, it should highlight the need for future research, which provides the reader with evidence that you have an in-depth awareness of the research problem. He further says that the function of your paper's conclusion is to restate the main argument. It reminds the reader of the strength of your main arguments and reiterates the most important evidence supporting those arguments. So, do this by stating clearly the content, background, and necessity of pursuing the research problem you investigated in relation to the issue, controversy, or a gap found in the literature. Make sure, however, that your conclusion is not simply a repetitive summary of the findings. This reduces the impact of the arguments you have developed in your study. According to him, a researcher should consider the following points to help ensure that his conclusion is appropriate. One, if the argument or purpose of your paper is complex, you may need to summarize the argument for the reader. Second, if prior to your conclusion you have not yet explained the significance of your finding, or if you are proceeding inductively, use the end of your paper to describe your main points and explain their significance. Move from a detailed to a general level of consideration. That actually we have already discussed that there should be an inductive method. So what does it mean? It means that move from a detailed to a general level of consideration that returns to the topic, to the context provided by the introduction, or within a new context that emerges from the data. Leora and Jerry, in their chapter on conclusion, describe the strategies on how to develop a compelling conclusion. And these strategies are, if your essay deals with a contemporary problem, warn the reader of the possible consequences of not attending to the problem. Then recommend a specific course or courses of action that, if adopted, could address a specific problem in practice or in the development of a new knowledge. Cite relevant quotation or expert opinion already noted in your paper in order to lend authority to the conclusion you have reached. A good place to work is research from your literature review. Then explain the consequences of your research in a way that elicit actions or demonstrate urgency in seeking change. Then relate a key statistic, fact, or visual image to emphasize the ultimate point of the paper. If your discipline encourages personal reflection, illustrate your conclusion pointing with the relevant narrative drawn from your own life experience. Return to an anecdote, an example, or a quotation that you presented in your introduction, but add further insight derived from the findings of your study. Use your interpretation of results to recast it in new way. Provide a take-home message in the form of a strong second statement you want the readers to remember about your research. Then there are some points that you should keep in mind to avoid while you are writing a conclusion. The research guide of the University of Southern California mentions about the points we need to keep in mind and problems to avoid while writing conclusion. According to them, a researcher usually makes the following mistakes while writing a conclusion. One, a conclusion should be concise. It should be concise and to the point and should not have unnecessary information in it. The researcher's emphasis should be on implications and evaluation rather than on methodological details. Secondly, focus should be on significant issues, because the job of the researcher is to use deduction method, the introduction and the induction method, the conclusion. In other words, a researcher should place his or her research in the larger context by focusing on the contribution it has made in the research field. Then, do not ignore the negative results. A researcher should definitely talk about the problems and challenges encountered by him or her, as it will make his or her research rich. The challenges faced by the researcher will pave way for the future research, and this will be a success for a researcher. Then he or she should provide a clear summary of the research. The summarization that is done in the conclusion should be very clear, or in other words, a summary should always be succinct. Conclusion should match your objectives. When you are starting your research, you always highlight the objective. Remember that your conclusion should match your objectives. A conclusion should always reflect on the researcher's achievement of his objective. Then it shows if the researcher has accomplished what he intended to accomplish in his or her research. It actually shows that if the researcher has accomplished what he intended to accomplish in his or her research. If there is any discrepancy, then the researcher should document the reasons and try to use it as a data in the research, and if possible, should try to go back and refine the original objectives. Then finally, conclusion should reflect researcher's confidence about his or her research. A researcher when conducts a research, he has a thorough understanding of his research than anyone else. So he should take advantage of this fact and should try to reflect that confidence and understanding of the research in his conclusion. Now, as we've understood what is a good conclusion, how to write a good conclusion, what should be avoided while writing a good conclusion, let's focus on how a good conclusion is drawn. So Shuttleworth has described a few points in highlighting or in explaining how to draw a conclusion. He sums up the whole thing in a very succinctly manner, and he says that the researcher can draw the conclusion in these 5 points. One, what he has learnt. First thing is, his conclusion should focus that what he has learnt in his research. The researcher will summarize what they have learnt from the research and their findings of the research. Doing so, he or she should try to assess strength of the hypothesis. For example, in a research, if a null hypothesis is acceptable, the researcher can analyze why the results were not as per the predictions in his or her conclusion. This will make his or her conclusion very strong. The researches where there is no hypothesis, like the O'Neill research, the researcher will analyze the findings and will try to establish if any valuable information is not covered. Aspects for the future research. When you are drawing conclusion, it should have aspects for the future research, because all researches leads to new research. A good conclusion should deal with the aspects of the future research. All researches lead to new research. Most of the researches uncovers the new questions, and researchers can use these to suggest new directions for the future study. If the hypothesis is accepted, the research results are as predicted by the researcher, and if a hypothesis is not accepted, it paves way for the future research. Then one should evaluate the flaws in the research. The researcher should try to analyze the problems that occurred during the experiment. First of all, he or she should try to analyze the errors in the research design that can influence the results in any manner. All experiments suffer some or the other kind of weakness error. The researcher should be able to justify the methodology and should try to give reasoning for the errors that have occurred in the experiment. Shuttleworth explains this with a beautiful example. He says that while drawing conclusion, the researcher may think that another variable influenced the results and this variable was not eliminated during the experiment process. A refined version of the experiment may help to achieve better results if the new effect is included in the design process. So, giving example of global warming, he says that in the global warming example, the researcher might establish that carbon dioxide emission alone cannot be responsible for global warming. They may decide that another effect is contributing. So, purpose is that methane may also be a factor in global warming. A new study would incorporate methane into the model. This argument also supports our previous point that deals with the new aspects for the future research. Then a conclusion should also talk about the benefits of the research. Once the researcher has evaluated the flaws, the researcher he or she should evaluate the advantage and benefits of the research. In explaining this point, Shuttleworth gives an example from the medicine and psychology field and says that in medicine and psychology, the result may throw out a new way of treating a medical problem. So, the advantages are obvious. However, all well-constructed research is used even if it is just adding to the font of the human knowledge. Suggestions based on the conclusions are very important. The last stage and one of the most important stage is the recommendation stage, which is based upon the results of researchers' field study. Researcher could make suggestions for refinement or of the experimental design or highlight the interesting areas for the further study. This final piece of the researcher's paper is the most critical and pulls together all the findings, and as stated earlier, it will pave way for the new research. So, this is the most important part. Then finally, when you are summarizing in a conclusion, the strength of the result is summarizing. The most important part about drawing conclusion is to check if the method and methodology used is used correctly in the research. This also calls for following of the steps of scientific research and design correctly. If the research design is strong, then the focus would be conclusion rather than the method. Shuttleworth explained the above points and make it very easy for a researcher to draw conclusion in a very effective manner. As we have analyzed the various aspects of drawing and writing a conclusion, like importance of a good conclusion, structure of a good conclusion, and things to avoid while drawing conclusion, let's briefly talk about the steps that are needed in the process of writing a conclusion. The first step that is needed in writing a conclusion is that the researcher should gather all the information at one place, write down each of the hypotheses and arrange the data from each dependent variable under its corresponding hypothesis. Attach the result of the statistical analysis with each hypothesis. If the data collected passes the test of reliability and validity, as it will help the researcher to decide if the hypothesis is false or true. But remember that the reliability and validity need not be perfect to provide useful information. So, while drawing conclusion, a researcher must try to check all the following points. One, first of all, the researcher should check if he has answered the so what question in the research, or in other words, what his or her research means or trying to say, or if the researcher has explained what the finding of his research, his or her research mean. The researcher should check if he or she has outlined the implication of his or her research for academic understanding, and if the implications are the policy are for policy practice. The researcher should also check if he or she has highlighted the limitations of his or her research, and his or her work is able to suggest areas of future research. A researcher need to provide a convincing explanation of his research, which is loud clearly so that it looks nice. Finally, he or she needs to proofread his conclusions so that all the errors can be checked. Now, as we have understood the various steps and the what is drawing conclusion, let's revise what we have done in this module. So, in this module, we have actually explained how do we draw conclusion. So, drawing conclusion, an important research process which helps the researcher in forming an impression of his or her research. The conclusion of the research not only summarizes the researcher's thought, but explain the contributions of the research conducted by him or her. Thus, one can say that the conclusion of a research helps the researcher in giving a blueprint of his research and leaves a last impression in the minds of the reader. The best or the most important role played by the conclusion is that it generates the new aspects for the future research. Thank you so much. I hope you are learning a lot from these modules of research methodology. For any queries, you can write to me. Thank you so much.